Hello everyone, this is Viesha, and today I'm going to show you how to use the editor to create your own maps in Wizards and Warlords. Let's get into it. Once you've launched it, you can see you have a default map, as you can see here, of 40-40, and with only oceans. So your first task will be to create a map, or you can try to generate it. Non-square map are not supported yet, so you only have the same number both. But you can change the size of your map, for instance 25 and 25, apply map size, and now I have a smaller map. You have a minimum of 20, you can go under that. Then you can generate random terrain and start creating from that. You can leave it like that, or you can try to create your own map. But let's try a new thing. First, we have terrain. Once you have created your terrains, you will be able to add rivers and select which kind of climate each row or each eggs can have. The climate is used especially for generating nodes and other things that can only happen in some biomes. Once your terrain rivers and climates are set, you will go into the provinces and you can create default names. But don't be afraid, because it's not mandatory. In fact, if you launch your map without creating provinces, the game will create them for you. Then you can add some dungeons, but at the moment it doesn't seem to allow you to create specifically which kind of dungeon you have. It's just a place with a seed, and the game will generate a random one from that. Then the scenario will let you add starting points. Once you've done with that, you can save. Once your game is saved, you can upload it to the workshop. Just let's see how it fares. First, the terrain. We have only ocean. Let's put a bit of grassland. You click once to add terrain one by one. If that is too slow for you, you can click the blob mode, and then you will have a flower of 7 eggs. But what if you want to fill a big map once? Then if I hold the mouse, I will move the map. But click hold mouse to draw, and you won't have any more panning. And then you just can fill whatever you want to. Let's get rid of that. Let's finish it. You have now your first shape. So we have ocean, we have crawling ocean inside something, and first use some hills. Where will it be higher? Put hills where you want, for instance there. We can call it an ancient Atlantide, for instance, and this internal lake was created, but before that there may be something, I don't know, why not. You can start creating a story for your map. Once you're done with it, and you can do it as fast as I'm doing it now, just be rough for now. Then place some mountains at the center to be the top places where will be coming your flowing rivers. Now that you have made this, I advise you to place rivers now. Rivers come from mountains and go to the sea. You know that, right? Don't forget to click again on your river. And now click again, choose a new river, and put as many as you want on your map. You can create deltas and some river heavy places. Your map will then have a more organic look. Make the river follow the hills up to the sea, for instance. Now, all we have, we come back to the terrain, and we use only grassland, but plains can be useful. Put plains where, in places that are not near a river, for instance. Put them like it comes to your mind, where you want them to go. Don't think too much. Just follow this simple rule. If there is no river, no hill, put plains. Simple, isn't it? You don't need to put everywhere. Then, now, you want to put some forest. Forest usually grow when there is enough water, so you can place them near rivers. You can place them by blobs. You have hills and we have forested hills. Don't forget to use that. It can be very useful. Just be a bit creative. Don't be afraid to. If you place too much, you will change them when you'll be fine-tuning your map. So now we have swamps and marsh. Look at the places where there are rivers, once again, so that's why rivers are very important. And for instance, it's logical to have marsh here. Why not here? Maybe here, there and there. Near the coast, maybe in place of that. And some swamps too. Near forests. Or near water. And soon you'll have a good looking map. Now, why not use desert to create some kind of beaches to give it that kind of look. Don't put it everywhere. Just where you feel it will look good. You can zoom in, zoom out to fine-tune everything. Now that your map is almost finished, you can add some small things. If you want to place some special places, but usually there will be only versions of what you've already placed, like mountains, plains and grasslands. Why not shrublands? You want to place them near plains, between plains and grassland. Usually they can be on the shore if they are up north. What? I can't click? Why is that? Okay, let's try to click somewhere else. Avoid water, because you wouldn't have shrubs. Replace some hills, for instance. And don't try to put everything everywhere, because you will have some places which are really flat, some places which are really hilly or mountain. And all those water will give some breath and life to what you've created. You can now add provinces. I won't put all the provinces, I will just only show you how to do it. For instance, first select an hexagon. Once you select it, click new and give it a name. For instance, first try add this editor. Now you see a border. Now click somewhere else and click add. You can also automatically generate provinces if you like or don't like them. But I'll start again. I've been. So create new province. First try-ish. Okay, now I click add. And the exits I select are added to my selection. I can't add the ocean. Once I've finished, I click add and I have my first Raish province. and their other province. Let's generate the rest. No, it doesn't generate all the rest, it just erase what you've done, so don't do what I've just done. It doesn't work like that. Okay, I didn't knew because I placed all the provinces by hand, and if you don't like it, you can just now save and upload to workshop, because everything will be generated on start. Like I did last time, if the shape of a province doesn't suit you, select an ex of the province, then click add, and click on the next provinces, and as you can see, it will add those exes to the selected province. Once you've done that, why not add some dungeons? Click on places that would receive dungeons, I don't know, this march. Or maybe these hill forests. And those beaches can have some dungeons. The game will probably create other dungeons for you, I'm not sure of that. As you can see, you can remove the dungeon seed, and if you let all those dungeons... Okay, now you can go to the scenario and you can select starting provinces. For instance, you want the possibility to start there. You can allow wizard, tribal chief and the player, or you can allow warlord, AI and AI. Or if you're like me and you're not sure what you're doing, just let anyone go there. Select places that are not dungeons, it's better like that. Or the game will crash because it will try to create a settlement or a wizard tower on a place that can't build anything due to the dungeon. So now this map is ready to play. You can try it, just save it. As you can see, it is under, but you can move it like that. You see, I have already created some. Give it a name. For YouTube, save, and that's it. You can then upload to workshop, upload as new item. But before that, before uploading your map to the Steam Workshop, you can add a JPG file for the thumbnail. You need to place the file in the user, username, appdata, local law, Valorant games, wizards, and warlords, as you can see there. This appdata folder is a hidden one. So before being able to access it, you need to check display hidden elements in the display menu at the top of your file explorer. There. The dev already know it is not convenient, and the place where the saves and maps are will probably change, but you'll still need to place a file with exact same name as your map. So, as you can see, I have northernkingdom.sce and northernkingdom.jpg in the same folder. So, as you can see, I've just showed you how to create a thumbnail. But now, let's get back to the last few things. The name generator. You can create a generic name, a dwarven elvish, for instance, a Greek name for male, for toponym basics, or toponym for region, and generate. And get a lot of different things. You can then copy paste everywhere or just copy paste with your own hands. Once you're done with that, you can exit, create a new game. When you want to create a new game, the next patch will let you click on the custom map. There is written no, because in fact it means there is no custom map actually chosen. It is the load button here that is used. Load for YouTube. Load. Select a wizard, a warlord, the number of opponents, difficulty as you wish. For instance, a wizard. Accept factions like I like them. It was a faction I created. And continue, continue. As you can see, the game created a whole new world to explore for me, for you, for whatever, whoever wants to try it. Then I hope to see you next time. I hope this video will find you well, and Vyosha, out!